Parental discretion is advised.
Find yourself in the Beachview area of Pittsburgh? Check out the official pizza of this show, Slice on Broadway, sharing an abnormal obsession with pizza we can relate to. Check them out at sliceonbroadway.com and tell them this show sent you. Hey guys, it's the Wrestling Mayhem Show episode 499. One more to the big 500. We flipped the odometer, sort of. I'm Mike Sorg at Sorgatron on the Twitter here in Pittsburgh, PA. Ready to talk professional wrestling on the flagship show, WrestlingMayhemShow.com. With me as typical, he's there. He's hanging out. He's with us. He's under his title for some reason. Papa Lunchbox joins us at DJ Lunchbox on the Twitter. Get your head above water, sir.
Hey, can you guys see my cat?
No, there's a title there.
Can you see him now? No. Oh, there he goes.
There we go. There he is.
There's
well,
the cat.
We had Bryce Remsburg's dog on the Indie Mayhem show, and now we have your cat. So
yeah, I want to make a quick announcement. I am going to be playing King George on the Chicago. What's the word I'm looking for? Not revolution. What is it? The revival, the Chicago revival of the Broadway smash hit Hamilton. I'm going to be playing King George, and it starts next week. I can't wait.
Awesome. And also with us, we're spanning the country. First of all, we just take a hop up to Poughkeepsie, New York, as Mad Mike joining us.
Hi, Sorg. How are you today?
Good. And also with us from California, it's the guy behind Power to the Smarks on the Twitter. I almost said that other thing. Occupy Pro Wrestling is the site. Alex Kars of the Chikara in 15 Minutes podcast.
Oh, radio, I'm back on the Mayhem Show.
We're going to have a lot of fun here talking TLC and so much more. Please check us out, WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Hit us up at Good Times.
Good times
at WrestlingMayhemShow.com or 412-206-WMS0. You can also check us out on the Facebook, on the Twitters, at Mayhem Show. And please subscribe to the show on iTunes, Stitcher, Spreaker, iHeartRadio, and YouTube, and so many more places you get your audio and video content from. Also, please support us as our friends do at patreon.com/wrestlingmayhemshow. You don't have to, spill the cash in order to do that. You can also just share the show. Whatever helps the Mayhem Nation grow, we appreciate it. Please do that. But you can go over there, just like our good friends, of course, Ed Burke, on there, as well as C-Row of the WrestlingRevolution.com. Diggity!
Woo!
And our friends at the Matthew and Jennifer Carlin's Foundation for Podcast Betterment. Thank you so much for supporting the show with your dollar. And so share the show however you want to support us. We appreciate all of the ways to get the word out and to help make it get bigger. So let's get into the show. First of all, TLC, Tables, Ladders, and Chairs, is this weekend. You know, the one we look forward to after every December when we said, oh, hey, there's one more pay-per-view in December before Royal Rumble. And it's that one with all the hardware. And we're setting up for it. And I know, Mad Mike, you expressed your excitement for TLC this year.
I did, Sork. It honestly surprised me as much as it surprises most people, I think. I was watching Raw last night, and I didn't really get spoiled on anything that happened.
Mm-hmm.
And, the opening segment just kind of hooked me. It was different, not too different, but it was different than what we've normally been seeing. And, we're getting a triple threat ladder match with New Day, Usos, and Lucha Dragons. That's going to be really fun. We're getting a four-on-four elimination tables match. I mean, that's going to be super fun, too. Roman and Sheamus may not be who we want to see in the WWE title match, but that's going to be a damn good match.
Mm-hmm. They're going to work their asses off.
Yeah, and I'm intrigued by what the hell they're doing with Paige and Charlotte, because for me, it seems like it's like kind of the first time they're doing heel versus heel for a Divas title, which I'm okay with. I mean, it's very intriguing. Like, for something that has not had that good of a buildup, I'm really excited for the pay-per-view. I think it's going to be a lot of really fun stuff.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It makes sense. If you're going to bring back all these ECW guys for anything, TLC absolutely makes sense. It's right up their alley. And again, kind of, I don't think it's too late to go to that well. We haven't done it for a while. We haven't seen Dudley's for a while, so it's all, it kind of makes us a little bit new, doesn't it?
Unless you're a fan of TNA, then yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. And you're like, right, right. Also, I want to give a shout to former IWC champions from this year, International Wrestling Cartel, Rhino and Tommy Dreamer, who had a cage match both in Meadville in back in April at Night of the Superstars, and Cage Fury, available on indiewrestling.us. No, that was really cool. We were excited to see him in Pittsburgh and even see Rhino come out. New beard Rhino, by the way. Are we signaling a Wyatt turn? I'd be down with Rhino and the Wyatt family, to be quite honest.
Ooh, yeah.
Hmm?
Rhino Wyatt?
Rhino Wyatt. That's right.
I don't know if that works.
He's like a big, violent, bearded Pokemon. Bray's like, Rhino, I choose you. Rhino uses spear. It's not very effective.
Rhino has mega evolved. He used gore. It's super effective.
No, I'm looking forward to that. I mean, are you kind of over your kind of Wyatt's issue at this point, or we're kind of putting that aside for how this is kind of building up?
I mean, they need to win.
Yeah, yeah.
They don't need to win.
They need to win something.
No, they are slotting into that Kane hole perfectly.
Yeah, yeah, kind of.
Kane doesn't win anything.
But see, it's different if it's just one guy not winning.
Mm-hmm.
If it's four guys not winning.
But to be fair, they've won some matches here in the last week, so.
It's also different with Kane because within like the first year or so, he won the WWE title.
Uh-huh.
You know, he was involved in all these major things, and to be fair, he was a pretty fairly dominant monster throughout all of it. I don't know when it all went south, but I mean, at least from the beginning. And then you have Wyatt, who started out, real strong in terms of like this whole face of fear thing, and then he lost to John Cena, and he's been losing ever since. I don't know. It feels weird to me. It feels a little disjointed at times.
Mm-hmm.
It's difficult to take him seriously as a threat. But I think this is like a perfect scenario because Dreamer, Rhino, and the Dudleys have nothing to gain from winning this match. They have absolutely nothing to gain. Dreamer and Rhino are just there on loaners. And the Dudleys are probably not staying much longer either. They're probably staying to get another WrestleMania paycheck and then get out.
But why not? Yeah. You know, I mean, why not cash in? You know, I think that's another thing to kind of bring a little bit of nostalgia, and WWE's high on this nostalgia right now. Yeah, we haven't touched on that for a while.
I kind of feel like Dreamer or Rhino is there because little Spike Dudley probably either wasn't contacted to do this or probably didn't want to do it.
Well, I mean, this is we're down to the reliable ECW guys at this point.
True.
Let's be honest. I mean,
true.
Because Tommy Dreamer had something out there that sounded like Sandman might be the guy coming in. I'm like, nah, no way that guy's sober. Or somebody
maybe,
like
maybe for one night,
maybe for one night. But it's just one of those like, there's a lot of fit factoring of is it worth of us to deal with X to bring this person back, right? And I mean,
are you saying we're not going to see New Jack?
No. Yeah, I mean, who else is there?
Could use a one night thing. I don't know.
I mean, there's the ones they like to work with, the ones that have been good to them. Obviously, Tommy Dreamer is a guy that have been there for a while. Same with the Dudleys, were built up even bigger because of their time in WWE. Rhino was a good hand for a while. And obviously, they brought him back for NXT, and that kind of put them in the purview to put them in. In this match here, they're the old reliables. You know, they're they're the responsible kids that came out of that class. And WWE uses them whenever they can, and they're the ones that aren't broken down too. They're ones that haven't been doing stupid stuff on the indies for several years, and have had to have charity shows to pay for their hospital bills, you know. And I think that speaks highly of them to WWE that they'll come back. So
I think it also kind of speaks poorly of WWE's inability to build two other guys they could have put the Dudleys with.
Yeah.
Because I mean, there are other tag teams that we could have used here, like the Primetime Players, or even just two other guys to go.
But I think anything else would have felt like just a random pairing. And I like this because it's like, this is a unit, this is a brotherhood. I think the story is stronger because of it. And you get that, other little bit. So I think it's pretty cool.
I agree with that. And I was just thinking too, like, I have a lot of respect for Dreamer and Rhino being on there. And I especially have respect for Dreamer doing himself and doing indie wrestling a favor by promoting House of Hardcore.
I don't know if I said this last week on the show, but I feel like Tommy Dreamer was in Pittsburgh because it wasn't quite so far away from where he's hanging out, and all they did was pay him a plane ticket and allowing him to wear his company shirt to the ring, you know. But which is really cool of them. I mean, that's really awesome that they do let him do that. You know, it's like it's an indie promotion. You know, even though it's owned by Tommy Dreamer, obviously, it's an indie promotion. You know, actually, let's look at it this way, because I don't know if you guys realize Rhino has also started a promotion up in Detroit. Nothing big. He's like running out of local VFW to kind of help them raise money and just have some nice, you know, good family shows with a bunch of local guys. Right. And he's obviously the big name on there. So they'll draw, you know, a half decent for it locally. But I mean, you're talking about like two guys that run wrestling promotions are in this match represented on here. I don't know. Of course, so is Booker T. I guess we're kind of in a different phase where guys can do that, you know. And I think that's pretty cool. I don't know. Rhino doesn't have a T-shirt for his Fed yet, but it's brand new. But by the way, speaking of TLC, while we've been kind of going here, holy crap! This cover art for their song with the scissors in the tongue. It was kind of throwing me off a little bit here for WWE. Just saying, the Wicked Ones by Dorothy. What? Really? Is the theme for a TLC, I guess. Okay, going down the line, de facto Kevin Owens replacer Alberto Del Rio is taking on Swagger in a chair match. I'm still pretty sure that was supposed to be Owens last week. Right, guys? I mean, it seems to kind of make sense. It's a little awkward this way. I watched that right last night, right? It was getting really tired. Zeb's gone, right? Did we just like did Zeb just ride off in the sunset again?
I think that's the case.
Yeah,
I think he's just gonna reunite with Swagger.
Okay, all right, fine. That's all right. And of course, Mike, you made mention about the ladies match. After last week, I dove into a lot of that old stuff on WWE Network. And there was something about the Miz TV with Charlotte and Paige that felt very Smoky Mountain to me. I don't know if you picked up on that kind of vibe as well, Mike.
Well, not really Smoky Mountain, but I did appreciate it. I mm-hmm. like Charlotte as a heel. I think she works better as a heel.
Mm-hmm.
And especially with her dad, like, right behind her saying, "Oh no, I know how this works. I've done this a whole bunch of times.
Mm-hmm.
We need to go."
Mm-hmm.
Like, but it still seems very heel versus heel to me. It's very weird.
Right. I thought we did a face turn on Paige, of a sort. Or we just don't, okay. Both girls are motivated, right? So it's not like back in the day where bitches be bitches, or however we said it before, when it just seemed like girls were just all catty and that's the only reason why any of them fought in the Divas division. I don't know. I want to see, hopefully we get some Paige on SmackDown so we can kind of see what the tone is. Because they can just be like, well, Charlotte's the bigger bitch in the situation, so Paige is, you know, the de facto world cheer for her. You know, in the long run, everybody's going to cheer for who the hell they want to cheer for anyways in this case, right?
Sorg, I think you're getting a weird SmackDown this week.
Oh, really?
Because they also filmed Tribute to the Troops.
Okay.
So I don't know who's going to be on as SmackDown, long as they're filming Tribute to the Troops at the same time.
As long as I don't see the creepy Christmas Strowman that Strowman Claus is coming to town. Yeah, as long as I don't see that on SmackDown, I'm okay with that.
Oh,
that...
I can't wait for SmackDown this week.
But I don't know. I don't think this is a model Rick Martel versus Shawn Michaels of SummerSlam 9 proportions. But I don't know. It is interesting. It actually adds a little bit more energy to it, doesn't it?
I would say so. I mean, I wanted to see Becky Lynch come out last night.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to see where she stands on this whole thing. I mean, I guess that's going to be probably the reveal at the pay-per-view, but... Mm-hmm. Like, I don't know. Is Becky Lynch the only face now in the Divas division?
I don't even know anymore. I think I'm supposed
to... I feel
to,
like it's hard to tell.
I think I'm supposed to cheer for Team Bad, right? Like, I want to. I did. Oh, but I'm just a huge...
so bad.
But after that dance...
All saved is gray.
After the completely random, unless you follow social media, uniting of Team Bad and New Day, which I hope that just means they all come out together from now on, to be quite honest.
Bad Day Rocks.
Yeah.
That gif is going to be my everything for all of 2016.
Yeah, and that's you know, I mean, that's beating the Wade Barrett dancing with the New Day thing from the last pay-per-view, which I thought was just absolutely incredible. But I don't know. Going down the line here, Kevin Owens, he's back from his sick leave, taking on Dean Ambrose. But the thing that happened last night, I'm sad that we got, you know, I'm glad Kevin Owens got to go home and he got to, you know, get better. But I'm sad that we missed another week of whatever happened there. Because I wish just Owens, Ambrose have a long-term plan so they can keep doing interesting things.
I'm surprised this doesn't have a stipulation on it.
I think we're out of stipulations because there's no more furniture. More or less. I mean, we're already doing... I always think this is kind of redundant when we do a TLC plus a ladder match, plus a chair match, plus the tables match. Wait, are we doing a tables match?
Well, they do call it tables, ladders, and chairs, or they don't call it WWE TLC.
That depends on how you look at the logo, I think.
No, I'm going by what Michael Cole calls it.
Michael Cole, what does he know? Well, it is a tables match versus the Wyatts and ECW originals. Now, here's a question. Is it
EV 3.0?
What?
EV 3.0.
No. One, nobody watched that to know what the hell you're talking about. Two, no. And three, as Shane Douglas told me for the nth time, Dixie Carter is a freaking moron. Ugh. You can see, by the way, if you want to see that, promo is on RWA's YouTube page right now. If you haven't heard the Shane Douglas Dixie's a moron rant, watch that video, and it's the same speech he gave in the same promotion, I think, about 3 years ago. So
Sork, I'm gonna need this video for the midweek war.
Go get it. It's up there. I'll Dropbox it to you. puts over RWA. Dixie sucks. But this guy in the ring, he's why we're not in the toilet. Boom, boom, boom. Hey, 3 point.
By the way, if they're out of furniture, I mean, they could always make Owens versus Ambrose a doors match. I mean, there's plenty of doors you can find in WWE.
Yeah.
No, if you're going to have
actually hitting each other with doors, though, it's just Ray Manzarek playing an organ while they fight each other.
It's going to be like a Scooby Doo chase. Where they're going to two doors and third class turnaround. It'll be great.
All right. First of all, if there's going to be a doors match in WWE, it needs to be between Bayley and Nia Jax. Secondly, if there was a doors match on a WWE pay-per-view and it doesn't have John Morrison in it, they've done it wrong.
It's the one he was born for. I get it.
Yeah.
I don't like it, but I get it.
It's not the worst thing I've heard.
That's true. That's true. But anyway, anything else about a title match, a triple threat match for the tag teams? It's going to be awesome stuff from these teams.
That match is
going to
be a lot of fun.
Yeah, this is going to be one of those great, like, you know, triple threats. Yeah, I think it's going to be good. Not quite as convoluted as we saw at WrestleMania for their ladder match. Or wait, am I confusing things? Like, I feel like, wait, they have a triple threat match? What was it that they had at WrestleMania? Where
they had like seven guys in it.
Right. Where the Usos got hurt, right?
You're thinking of the Fatal Four Way at the pre-show.
Right. Exactly. You know, but no, I think it's going to be fun. We have plenty of talented teams in that, and of course the title match, which I think they've done a really admirable job. Sheamus is, I want to say, as good as Seth Rollins, but he's definitely kind of filled the shoes very, very nicely, as we talked about in the last couple of weeks on the show.
It is a welcome pace not seeing the Authority saying how we love our champion, but at the same time, we're not sure if we like our champion every week.
Mm-hmm. That's true. LB, what are you looking forward to on TLC here coming up?
As with most things nowadays, anything featuring the New Day.
Mm-hmm.
If the New Day are involved, I'm on board. That ladder match sounds like a treat. Mm-hmm. And I'm very much on board for that. And I'm morbidly curious about Sheamus and Father of the Year.
Father of the Year. There'll be a lot more discussion on Father of the Year here coming up in the next couple of weeks. Actually, next couple of months, I guess.
I didn't know Sheamus was wrestling Titus O'Neil. That's awesome.
That's right.
That's gonna be a slammy.
Oh,
slammy. Wait, is it really? Is it going to be a slammy? I'm going to be pissed if it's a slammy because
the slammies are in 2 weeks.
We're actually considering, is it in 2 weeks? I thought it was next week. Because we're actually considering Father of the Year as a Mayhem-y award.
Fine, we'll beat him to the punch.
Mm-hmm. We're doing Mayhem-y?
No, we won't because we'll be recording it for January.
Well, we just need someone to leak it to Reddit.
Ugh. Well, no, I already got banned by Reddit.
He's the most technologically aware of all of us.
On a side note, if any fans are there out on Reddit, we need an agent of WMS on Reddit to help us out. Because, hey, they don't like self-promotion, but if you just happen to like our stuff, that'll be... I don't know. I'm trying to figure out Reddit. But anyways, I just know if we put something on there and it can explode. We saw some cool stuff off of there. Here's... How did a concussion-addicted dreamer pass the physical and not Daniel Bryan from Garza?
I'm telling you, Dreamer didn't even take the protocol. He just wants to promote House of Hardcore, and he doesn't care if he gets beamed in the brain doing
it. Well, it's not
about
him.
It's not a concussion. It's a traumatic ocular headache or whatever.
side note, the promo in question is linked in the chat room, Mike. So if you want to snag that for later. Sheamus is as good as Rollins, I'm dead. What?
No, honestly, I think he is.
As good as Rollins?
Yeah.
Oh, honey, no.
No, not in the ring, but on the promo-wise.
I'm talking promo-wise.
Yeah, not in the ring. Obviously, Rollins is better in the ring. But Sheamus doesn't have bad matches.
No.
Unless he's wrestling Randy Orton.
Sheamus remembers his line. That's good enough for me.
Yeah. Alex, anything before we move on here, anything you're excited about in particular for TLC?
Other than them renaming it back to Armageddon, I'm actually very excited for the card because I feel like people give WWE a lot of flack for these stipulation themed pay per views,
mm-hmm.
but I've always kind of liked how they do book towards the different kinds of matches. Like you've got your ladder match, you've got your tables match. Apparently, you've got your chairs match. We may or may not have our stairs match, but the important thing is they're at least doing some effort to book towards these different stipulations, even though usually you'd see it being kind of almost the other way around, where it builds towards something to blow the feud off. At least we got something. Mm-hmm. I'm looking forward to the card as a whole, basically.
Good, good. You know, we'll see how that pans out. Well, guys, if you want to check out some pro wrestling, maybe you're tired of the stipulation, maybe whatever the case may be, and we want to try something different, try indiewrestling.us. We got a lot of cool stuff over there, including, hey, two guys are going to be in the pay-per-view, a cage match from back in August at Cage Fury 2015 between Rhino and Tommy Dreamer. Great stuff. They were great guys to work with in the IWC. Or this past weekend, Season's Beatings. Shane Douglas was a part of that show. A match of the year candidate. There was chanting match of the year before the match was even over between Amazing Red and Jason Gorey, a friend of the show. Really, really cool match to watch. A lot of fun stuff happening in the Renegade Wrestling Alliance as well. Sanjay Dutt in a great match with a guy that I can't pronounce his name because he's very Japanese. I was introduced to him. He's very Japanese. But tremendous stuff going on over there. Tremendous stuff going on with the IWC. IWC with a show this weekend, even. IWC's Winner Takes All happening up down in Elizabeth. So please check that out. Also, check out the great column by our own Matt Cartlands around the Indies with details about Chikara's big season finale and their first mainstay women's. The main champion is a woman, Miss Queen Kimberly, I believe it is. We talk a lot about that. We talk a lot about that. Cars, you're the expert with it as the guy behind the Chikara in 15 Minutes or Less currently podcast. And of course, we talked with Bryce Remsburg over on the Indie Mayhem show about that as well, which you can also find on indiewrestling.us. VOW tournament, Lords of Anarchy tournament, deathmatch tournament up there as well. Border City Wrestling. We have a great, if you follow us on social media, US Indie Wrestling on the Twitter or Indie Wrestling US on Facebook. We have an advent calendar sale. That means that we have a different sale every day through Christmas. Currently today, I believe today we are doing a sale 50% off with the code Advent. What's today? The 8th? Advent 8. And you can get that Lords of Anarchy for 50% off digital download. And we'll have something different tomorrow. Yesterday it was Montreal Theory. You missed it. Should have followed us on Twitter. Check out indiewrestling.us. All right, so let's move on. Speaking of indie wrestling, we're going to dive into a little piece from that because I think there's an interesting discussion to go on around it. Not to get into any political kind of aspects, but so there was kind of a throwdown on social media because we love when people are all kinds of upstanding citizens on social media around here, right, guys? In pro wrestling, because absolutely everybody is, right? I mean, come on, nobody's messed up on social media in pro wrestling.
Yeah, we're not interested in news items.
No, not at all. But of course, there's a video going around Joey Ryan who struck viral video gold. I think he was in Japan, if I'm not mistaken. I don't know. Amin might be lurking, so he can correct me out there.
It's called DDT. I don't remember what it's called or what it stands for, but.
But I think one of the words is dong. But there was a little bit of a video.
It is now.
That's what they're known for. Might as well lean into that. You know what I mean?
TLC and D.
How do you win that match?
Well, sir, you have to finish before you're allowed to climb the ladder.
Okay.
Solid. That makes sense.
That's what we're talking about.
But there was a move, and Joey Ryan, we've seen him locally with the IWC and Ring of Honor. Yeah, he's been in Ring of Honor, I think. He's a very porn star ish type. Oh, I did not watch the Grado video. I'm sorry about that. So they did a thing where he grabbed his junk, and it hurt him. Mm-hmm. It's a very hilarious clip. Am I accurately describing this for our audio listeners?
Sorg gets a test of strength with fist versus penis.
Fist versus penis. Okay. Okay.
Also, the name of my favorite Chikara Trios match.
Fist versus Penis. See, Cars gets it because there was a team called Fist.
Not okay, bad Mike.
Okay. Oh no! Yeah, we just broke Cars. Okay, and that's the last time Alex Cars will be on the Wrestling Mayhem Show. But this led to controversy because Jim Cornette responded. I don't even know why he like caught on to this. Somebody asked.
He has nothing else to do.
Somebody asked, but he says.
You remember last time I was on the show and I talked about how Vince Russo continues to talk as if his opinion matters in professional wrestling?
Right, right, right.
Just copy and paste that, but where it says Vince Russo, replace it with Jim Cornette.
Right,
I was
exactly.
Going to say replace 1990s with 1980s.
Something like that. But he responded to a fan and says, won't watch the video, but somebody apparently asked if he had seen the video. He says, won't watch the video, but the pic from Joey Ryan Online appears to enjoy staying over men with his something, something, something. And that turned into, saying, hey, that's really homophobic, et cetera, et cetera. And then it led to a conversation about kind of, Jim Cornette going into a tirade about, about being an embarrassment to wrestling and everything. And of course, we just had a big conversation about Chikara. Alex talks about it every week, right? And I think this is just an old thought here. And we talk about a variety of things like Lucha Underground. Did you know some people don't like Lucha Underground?
Sork, who
are those
people
who have not watched it?
Can we shoot those people into the sun?
Whoa! And yes, with a copy of USWA.
You mean GWF?
No, I swear I was watching USWA this week. I don't know. There were a lot of letters and a lot of people with mullets and a lot of Jim Cornette, okay? Which,
can't wait to watch Global Force on the WWE.
It's not the Global... No. It's Global Force.
But by the way, anyways. Sork... on ProWrestlingTees.com, there is apparently a Joey Ryan King of Dong style shirt.
Yes, there is, because Joey Ryan knows how to capitalize on this kind of stuff. But I think it's a good point of, hey, guys, there's a lot of wrestling out there these days, and there's a lot of creativity in wrestling these days. And while, we're kind of... like we talked about last week about the old wrestling, we had the Smoky Mountains, USWA popped up, Stampede's on there. There's a lot of great, great, great stuff. But can you really say there was a lot of variety in comparison back then? Like, I feel like even though the stuff is great, it's all just a version of what they're doing down the road. Now, granted, there wasn't a lot of crossover. These were territories, right? It's not like today where we get to see what... Dong Fu is doing over there in Japan and DDT. I think obviously Jim Cornette's of another era in that respect. But this is the sport quote that had the gobbledygooker. You know what I mean? Adrian Adonis, Gorgeous George, and you're gonna throw down on that.
Mae Young gave birth to a hand.
And I think that closes the discussion. Unless anybody has anything else to say on that. Alex, Will, LB?
No. Oh, man.
You can't really follow that up, can you, at that point?
I mean, as far as I'm concerned, everyone loves something different about wrestling.
Mm-hmm.
Some people love Chikara and, everything about that. Some people love the current WWE product. Some people don't. They love the Attitude Era, the new generation. Before that, some right. people enjoyed the era of Jim Cornette. I know Jim Cornette seems to enjoy the era of Jim Cornette. But, everyone has their opinion. I don't know. I think the whole thing kind of, I've been a fan of Joey Ryan. I mean, not everything about Joey Ryan I'm a fan of, but the wrestler, in general, I've been a fan of for quite some time. I met the guy in 2012, there's just, things about Joey Ryan that, I do enjoy watching. And so the whole video and the Jim Cornette thing aside, everyone just has their own opinion about it, but, it's very telling of the different eras of wrestling when you have a conversation like that on Twitter in 2015.
Right, right. LB, you got anything to say before we roll on?
No, I'm good. Fuck Jim Cornette, that's all.
Good point on that. All right, guys. Hey, you know what we can all agree on around here? Slice on Broadway. And I'm sorry, Alex, you're a little too far out of the delivery zone out in California.
Just mail me a postcard with a picture of
I'm going to take a slice. I'm going to throw a stamp on the slice, this slice of slice pepperoni, and send it out your way, man.
Please let it be pepperoni scented.
Oh, great stuff. Oh, I'm getting hungry again. It's sliceonbroadway.com. Check them out there if you're in the South Hills of Pittsburgh ever. Some great stuff right here along those tracks in Beachview on the in Pittsburgh city limits. It's around Carnegie, PA. Great stuff, great ingredients, a great creative pizza artist, you could say, perhaps. I don't know. Is that copyrighted by anything else? Sandwich artist, I'm thinking, right? Screw those guys.
Yeah, that company has enough things to worry about.
Yeah, they kind of do. Some great stuff. Rico down there is super awesome. The staff is great. We actually just picked some up. We had a filming for Sawtooth Willie this past Friday, and wanted to feed them. We got the Gonzo. And it was great since we were amassing an audience for these tapings, LB, and it's pretty fantastic.
Yeah. We had four people there just to watch.
Just to watch.
Including or that's not including Sawtooth and you.
Yeah, that's right. Just watching us filming a web series, apparently. I would just start selling tickets or something. But hey, this ad is about Slice on Broadway. It was delicious. It everybody loved it. They've been supporting us, Pittsburgh Podcasting, with pepperoni pizza for over a year and a half. Check them out, sliceonbroadway.com, PJH_slice on the Twitters, and of course, Facebook and Instagram. Get hungry too. Let them know you learned about them on the Wrestling Mayhem Show. And we'll be right back after this look about last week in Sorgatron Media.
Have you interacted with the train in such a way where you had to run alongside it for any reason?
Had to? No, did, yes.
Ah!
Do you have to have the little A thing for them to deliver on?
Yeah, do I have to put like a little like Amazon square? Yeah, you do. She picks it up.
Yeah, she picks it up.
Yeah, it lands right on the little A. I guess it looks for it. Mm-hmm. And then you pick it up and you take your A inside. So I got to run out back.
This is the Amazon landing zone.
Yeah, exactly.
Years ago, I got to be a part of Team Taz, and one of the things he really liked about me was my promos and creativity, and that I had a brand, and I made sure everything stayed on brand. And I was trying to think of a way that I could do promos and make them a little bit more interesting.
And then we found out the reason we haven't seen front of the show Logan Shulo for the last almost 2 years is he's been freaking doing an album with Jim Johnston because the Drifter got a music video debuted this week, man. Check it out. Yeah. And it sounds good. We're back. We got our game faces on. It's the Wrestling Mayhem Show, $4.99. We're acting like we've done this before. Because we've kind of done it 499 times.
It's a little kinda.
Kinda.
I like how you said kinda.
Kinda. I think I missed the week. But anyways, it's time for the big question. The biggest of big questions. From Not Mad Mike. LB. It's the LB button.
Yeah.
It's the big question button. What is the biggest question of professional wrestling this week?
Well, here's the thing. The Royal Rumble's coming up, which has me excited. So I love the Royal Rumble. I love it. TLC also coming up. Big fan of TLC. That's going to be a lot of fun. And I started thinking even further to the future. Like, we're probably going to have some crazy returns at the Royal Rumble and everything like that. And, you know, who knows what's going to happen? So I decided to open the floor to maybe some rampant speculation. And the big question this week to the assembled panel and everyone watching at home is, what is WrestleMania 2016 going to look like?
wait, as a whole or
Or just the main event, like the
whatever you like. What's gonna happen?
Like pick a thing is what we're talking about, right?
Yeah, pick a thing and tell us about it.
I gotta say, is there really, like, last year we're like, oh, Sting's gonna do a thing. Oh, this is gonna happen. Oh, Roman's probably gonna take on Brock, right? Like we kind of had that idea at this time. Do we really have as much of an idea at this point? Like, is there any? Oh, Undertaker's gonna do X, right? Like,
do they really have an idea?
That's why it's fun. What's going to happen?
It's questionable. It's certainly questionable.
That's why it's rampant speculation instead of accurate speculation.
Wait.
Okay. All right. Hold on. You want wild speculation?
Rampant.
Yes. Fine.
That is the parameters of the question.
Here is my rampant speculation. Okay. You ready for this? You ready? Dean Ambrose wins the Royal Rumble. But the night after Fastlane, rejuvenated and healthy Seth Rollins comes out to demand his rematch, and we get Shield Triple Threat at WrestleMania. Go!
Well, I don't think we are, because Rollins isn't going to be ready, right?
I think he will be.
You think he's going to John Cena this thing? You think they just told us that was going to be 9 months, so we wouldn't expect it?
If CrossFit has taught us anything, it's that motherfuckers are superhuman.
Okay, all right. CrossFit! Okay, I got it. What about you, Alex?
Alex, you're muted.
I'm thinking, too. Because it's a very good point, and actually I was thinking about this the last few days. It's like, there really isn't that much that appears to already be looked ahead at as far as WrestleMania goes. I am looking forward to, honestly, almost pretty much anything Kevin Owens does come WrestleMania. Like, for me, it would just be a moment. Actually, if you want to talk strictly dream booking, Kevin Owens defends the Intercontinental Championship against Sami Zayn.
I could see that.
Strictly dream booking. But
I think we're going to have, whereas we've kind of been unhappy with the women's title matches so far, I would love to see, I think we could see, a non-convoluted, full-on Charlotte versus Sasha at WrestleMania.
Ooh, yeah, that'd be great.
Think about that.
I can see it.
They pull out all the stops and they let them have a NXT TakeOver style match in freaking Dallas Stadium.
I almost want to throw in the other two Four Horsewomen in there.
In the match?
Just
no.
Say fuck it. Yeah, well, why not?
Okay. Oh, that would
Bailey's
be the dream.
Because Becky's already part of it.
Okay.
Becky's already part of it. If you bring Bailey up, because at that point, she will have already lost the NXT women's title to either Asuka or Nia Jax.
Right.
I'm assuming. And, I mean, WrestleMania is in March. That's a long time away.
Yeah. You could do some stuff.
If Bailey's
not
up by then, there's something wrong.
Yeah. I think it's more room. You know, it's getting crowded up there. It's not a matter of, oh, you're ready. It's you're ready and we got something to do with it. You know what I mean? For the next 3 weeks or whatever the case may be. I think that's the thing. LB, you gotta have an answer to this.
I'm gonna safe bet Wade Barrett will be on the pre-show. Safe bet.
Sorry, Matt.
John Cena will have a high profile match.
Undertaker.
I love this.
Safe bet.
By the way, him and Undertaker, I think, would be killer. And I think they should
John Cena and the Undertaker.
I think that's something people would just blow their minds for.
I would be into that. Mm-hmm. Let them reignite their feud from when John Cena pissed on the Undertaker's gravestone.
Yeah, he's still mad about that.
Yeah, I mean, they only have two big money Taker matches left, and one doesn't look like it's physically going to be able to happen.
Nope.
If John Cena beat the Undertaker at WrestleMania, the noise that the internet would make would give me an erection that would last until the next Royal Rumble.
All right, that's how you want to think about it.
Would be incredible. Joey Ryan at that point.
I think you got competition. You're good. You're good at that point. Yeah, yeah.
More outlandish booking. The McMahons are going to get involved in some kind of a match. I think they've been out of the picture long enough that it's probably going to happen.
Maybe the Rousey thing will happen. Right. I'd hope.
No, she's going to be filming Roadhouse.
Oh no. Okay.
Yeah, and The Rock is going to be filming too. So,
Mike, I know you have something coming up. We can't get to the chat first.
I have one more rampant speculation.
Okay. Okay.
If we don't get Sami Zayn on the main roster, because I don't think we're going to by then, because we need to figure out something to do with Brock Lesnar.
Brock Lesnar's going to come out and say hi. We know he's going to be there because he's going to be. They announced him for Pittsburgh the couple weeks beforehand. So,
Sorg, I want Brock Lesnar versus Kevin Owens. In fact, when we do Mayhem Mania, I'm calling dibsity dibsity dibs on making that my first match. yeah.
That'd be great. That'd
so
be
there's
so
that.
That'd be so great. Yeah.
Just imagine him promoing against Heyman.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Okay. Anyway, sorry. Anyways, you want to go to the chat.
From the chat. Sorry, I'm contemplating here. From the big question. Garza saying deja vu. Lesnar versus Brock 2. Wait, what?
Lesnar versus Brock 2. That Roman, would be a great match.
Roman Reigns supreme. I don't think that's right. Immortals. Taker versus Cena in Taker versus Cena in a match 5 years late. Seth from Carlin. Seth Rollins will commandeer Zeb Scooter. Triple H versus Reigns. Winner becomes Rock's cousin.
They've been setting up Triple H versus Reigns. I wouldn't be surprised if he's not champion that's going to happen. That's going to be like their big money match.
I feel like perhaps Reigns was like what happened at the end of Survivor Series was the plan. I feel like potentially maybe that was the plan the whole time. And which would have led to Rollins Triple H, let's say, at WrestleMania. That's my guess. I'm just rampant speculation of a sort. Nikki versus Charlotte seems more likely for WrestleMania. I guess so.
I think the Bellas are going to be pretty much out of the picture by Mania.
You think so?
I think so. I think they're, because I know their contracts are coming up.
According to Total Divas.
Has told me as such.
Jeez.
No, seriously.
Becky versus Paige versus Sarchar versus Banks. So we talked about that one. Fuck that. Four Horsemen versus Total Divas plus Maria Menounos. Hey, at least somebody can carry
sign
it, right?
Me up for that. I'm yeah. Okay with that.
You
one.
Know what? Let's give you Maria. Paul Heyman will open challenge for anyone that can beat Brock Lesnar in a Cell Saga-like tournament. Cell Saga as in Dragon Ball Z from Bobby FJ Town. Nobody will be able to until Daniel Bryan, who emerges from the training into the time chamber to take him down.
I was.
Bobby really had that playing out, didn't he?
Daniel Bryan in the hyperbolic time chamber is now my new fan fiction.
Oh boy, in a reverse battle royal.
and Bobby also said New Day will play video games on the giant screen at Jerry World.
Yes,
which is highly probable.
You know, exactly. You know,
all the buys.
Woods is sitting back in there like it's going to be the best. He started up, up, down, down just to have a chance to do that. Think about the timing. Think about it. I think it works.
Mm-hmm.
And reservations about Brock versus KO from Carlin's.
Somebody will finally be the internet champion. And Zack Ryder
exactly.
Will be
there. Brock Zack Ryder will finally defend his internet championship against Mojo Rawley. The hype bros explode!
I'd be okay with that, actually. As weird as that sounds, I'm okay with that.
I can just imagine Bobby being
I want that as
out
like,
of the chat room right now.
I want that as like the one of the semi-mains on the takeover the night before WrestleMania.
Can I make a appeal here?
Sure, Sorg.
Thank you for giving me permission. Thank you. Thank you. It's 499 episodes, and I ask permission still. Can the Miz get an inch here? Can the Miz get a spot?
No. That's silly.
Like, can the Miz get another shot at the top? You know, like,
you know what, Sorg? There are so many guys who haven't had one shot.
Yeah, I guess so. It's crowded.
Zack Ryder hasn't had one shot.
He's got movies happening.
He did. His shot just wasn't that high.
I mean, the Miz is on track to become the next Dean Cain at this point.
Dean Cain?
So...
Wait. I don't know.
So he's going to die in Supergirl too?
Yeah.
What? Spoilers! What the hell?
That's not spoilers.
I'm three episodes
actually
behind.
Spoilers. Thanks for that.
Yeah, thanks a lot. Thanks a lot.
Never mind.
You can say, no,
son
it's not. That doesn't mean it's not
son
a spoiler.
Son of a bitch. So I'm going to ask permission to kick you off the show now.
That's okay.
Thank you very much.
I only watch Gotham anyway.
Listen, I'm a cord cutter. That's a spoiler, okay?
It's the first episode.
What?
Yeah, never mind.
You don't kill him in the first episode?
Yeah. No, they said he was dead.
That's okay. I don't want to watch it anyway.
I don't know. Anyways, I don't
Matt
think.
Says,
welcome to the Rambling Movie Minute.
Matt says Miz versus Becky versus Charlotte.
Hey, you know what? If Queen Kimberly can get the main title out of Chikara,
Princess Kimberly.
What? Oh, Princess Kimberly. I'm sorry. I don't know. I'm sorry. I'm not caught up on Chikara. I'm sorry. Then yes, we can have Miz go for that. You know what I mean? I think that'll be fine.
For far too long, a woman has held the Divas Championship. Damn it, we need equality.
I thought Tyler Breeze would fill that role, though. I mean, that's what they seem to be building him up for. What, now that he's on the main roster, I mean.
Rumble in Orlando, so 95% chance a NXT guy debuts. There will always be one.
You know who's going to be in that Rumble in Orlando?
Hmm.
Bobby Roode!
Ooh.
Yeah.
Man. And then he'll get confused.
He's out of the World Title Series, Sorg.
Then he'll get confused because it's not a reverse Battle Royal.
No, and then James Storm's going to come out, and we're going to get beer money in WWE, Sorg!
Oh.
You want rampant speculation? I'll give you fucking rampant speculation.
And there comes your Coors Light sponsorship. WWE knows what they're doing here. I get that.
I'm just surprised that anyone from TNA didn't get confused when they call Battle Royal Battle Royal and then a gauntlet.
What?
TNA calls their Battle Royals gauntlets.
That's weird.
Just to be different.
That's weird. All right. So there are some interesting news. Actually, Garza shared with us very early in the show. There was a survey out to the, what do they call this, the fan WWE fan committee or something like that. There were questions along the lines of, and we've seen another survey in recent weeks made this kind of question the direction of what they're doing with WWE. It asked whether WWE or WWE NXT did a better job or an equal job of the following. Now, here's the list. This is kind of a long list, so bear with me, please.
So we're going to take this survey. I got to take the survey.
Yes.
I mean, that was lopsided for the end.
It was interesting. Do you have the word list of what you had to describe WWE programming as?
Right. So this is the did a better job or equal job at the following. And this is including, and this is a long list, bear with me, seeing good rivalries and matchups, feeling part of a large group of passionate fans, getting an appropriate amount of surprises, being amazed, being amused, being entertained, having a great show to watch with family, having a great show to watch with friends. We know the answer to the friends part. Seeing a wide variety of divas. That's a goal. Seeing enough of my favorite divas. Watching athletic moves and maneuvers. Seeing the quality of in-ring wrestling I want. Hearing compelling dialogue / promos. Getting the right mix of unique characters. Seeing a wide variety of superstars. Watching interesting stories play out. Seeing enough of my favorite superstars. Is this a rating system that you're doing?
Yeah.
Is it one of those best to worst in like dot format kind of things?
Well, first they ask you to rate WWE based on those things. Yeah. Then they ask you to rate NXT based on those things.
Yeah.
And then they ask you to compare who did better at what thing, WWE, NXT, or they don't both do an equal job.
Okay. Okay.
Spoiler alert for my answers on the survey, it was mostly NXT.
you just went NXT, NXT, and tick, 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 NXT.
Kind of. I mean, something I did give it serious thought. Some things I put that they equally performed.
Well, what do you, physicality. Okay, physicality.
Both brands are very equal on.
What did you think WWE did over NXT better?
Because that's one of the questions too. Like, why do you prefer NXT over WWE? And I say it's because of the storylines. It's because of the characters. It's because character motivations mean a big deal. Like, that's really kind of the point of NXT, is that you have to follow the storylines. WWE, you can jump in any week and it's the same old stuff over and over again.
Yeah, I can see that. And also, I see which of the following terms describe NXT? A survey question asked fans to pick which of the following terms describe NXT and then the main roster. And it's again, energy, authentic, hardcore, fantastical. Fantastical, really? Hokey, unique, excitement. But also, is it fair to compare the, what are we up to? 7 hours of main programming weekly of WWE to NXT?
Well, I mean, they're making us compare it, so I think
that's true. Apparently they do. Okay. Yeah. And also,
if they're asking us to compare it, I think it's more than fair that we do.
Mm-hmm. And it is interesting because now that there's no brand split, there's also, and I think part of it, do I see enough of my diva or superstar? Man, I haven't seen so-and-so for a few weeks. I haven't seen Alicia Fox in forever. Yeah, because she's been doing superstars matches for the last 3 months. You don't know. There's no way to follow your superstar I'm a Kevin Owens fan, and not that he would be there, but I didn't see Kevin Owens or wow. Oh, he's got a match on SmackDown. You don't know. There's no interweaving of that kind of stuff. They'll show, hey, this match is happening on SmackDown, but if they have 3 hours, you can let us know what's happening Thursday, okay? And I know the story can change or whatever, but I feel like there could be more teasers to make me tune in on SmackDown.
But Sorg, I think it's also the fact that there's oversaturation of certain people.
Yes. You're talking about between the two
shows. Way oversaturation of a lot of guys. Like, what? They have a huge roster, even with all the injuries they have.
Right.
Where's Damian Sandow?
Right, right.
Like, where? There are guys that should be on other shows. Like, why not put Rusev on main event every now and then? He doesn't need to be on every Raw.
No, and I think, I think somebody like him, he's in a certain level where he is. But then Stardust is still at a point where they'll pop down and do a match with the Ascension on Superstars.
No, but I think that should be with everyone. Like, but Roman Reigns should be on main event once.
Is there any rhyme or reason?
Because otherwise, if you tell me that Stardust is wrestling Neville on main event, guess what? That's not a main event. That's a mid-card match on Raw at best.
Hey, you know what? I watched the show named Superstars, and I saw matches with Spark Plug Holly. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but Sorg, Superstars, Superstars is just the name for guys.
Yeah, it's true. That's true.
So, main event.
Okay. Saturday night's main event.
When was the last time the WWE champion was on main event?
Right. When it premiered on Ion Television.
Exactly my point.
Yep. And you're going to see the same thing. I know we were kind of joking around on the Facebook group and some other places. Well, hey, SmackDown's going to feel like an A show for about 3 weeks. Well, we're trying to make you all tune in on. And I think as a mentality also that's kind of flawed too, because the main event settled into Superstars. SmackDown's, whenever they make a move from a Thursday to a Friday and back again or to a different network, yeah, it A shows for a little bit and then,
Or if SmackDown is live.
Yeah, or the random live one, of course. That's it. I guess the other point is, other than they get the advertisers, whatever, Do we need SmackDown at this point?
Yes.
It's yes. Why yes?
I was just saying, yes, that's fine.
What?
Are you just saying it?
I'm just saying it because if there's no SmackDown, there's nothing for me to write about every week.
Okay.
I'm not going to write about Raw. No.
Okay, that's a reason.
Everybody else does that.
He's not. Sorry. Okay, he's allowed to have that.
SmackDown needs a purpose.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like it's just like a wrestler. It's like a wrestler. If they don't have a purpose, if they don't have a focus, we don't need them on TV. SmackDown doesn't have a focus and a purpose, we kind of don't need to watch it.
And we stop watching it.
Remember the brand split?
Yeah. That was a great time.
It was good. And for a time, we considered SmackDown the A show.
Now, that's because it was.
Yeah, well, it was.
It was legitimately the better show.
Very much. It was.
That's why they ended it.
All praise be. All praise be to Paul Heyman and Kurt Angle and Brock Lesnar.
Well, Matt Carlins is asking in the chat room, is it possible it's what killing WWE isn't the 3-hour Raw, but the end of the brand split? I don't agree with that, because if you have a brand split, if we think a 3-hour Raw is a lot of repetition now, imagine if they had half the roster. That would be a lot of the same guys over and over again for 3 hours. Unless they just literally changed the way they do things and they put jobber matches on Raw.
Yeah, which is okay.
It absolutely is. Like, they do it on NXT all the time.
I mean, Raw used to be just jobber matches when it started. I think when you put it in that context, you would use the 3 hours differently. But
you would think, but WWE might disagree with you.
Yeah, right. There needs to be a cleanse. WWE needs to fail.
Whoa.
What? No, I mean, no, I mean, they're not, okay. Wait, there needs to be a final solution. No, that's not right either.
Whoa, Jesus Christ.
To WWE. No, they need to.
There needs to be a new day. Yes, there is.
They need to fail. They really do need to fail. They need to, and I really hope, and I feel bad because right now they're failing in the ratings department when all the new guys have popped up, which justifies bringing back your Brock Lesnar, John Cena, Randy Orton, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. You know, it's like it feels kind of like the times where Hulk Hogan would not show up on WCW strategically, so he could blame the fact that the ratings were because he wasn't there, not because they were going up against the NBA Finals. You know, that's what it feels like right now, to no fault of the guys there, right? Can anybody deny that like these guys on the top across Raw right now aren't working their freaking asses off with what they're given, right?
Well, I mean, Owens, Ambrose, Reigns against the guys.
What's that?
It's never been anything against the guys.
No, not for us. Definitely not for us.
The performers have been kicking ass.
Yeah, but it's not resonating enough for more than 3 million viewers, which is a problem for them. So
yeah, I think as far as the WWE TV situation goes, I think they need. You know, for the longest time, they've considered Raw to be the flagship show. So I think they need to take that word flagship very seriously. And they can handle that one of two ways. One, they can use Monday Night Raw to actually set the tone for the rest of the week, whether it's main event, maybe not NXT because it's, you know, kind of a separate brand at this point anyways.
Right.
But like main event, superstars, and then SmackDown. Or they can take the term flagship literally and have Monday Night Raw on a cruise ship every week.
And I think on that point, we have solved all of our problems. Ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, I want to see Ryback on a twisty slide now. No, but we just need to reboot.
No, they do. They definitely do.
We need a reboot. Where everyone's reboot happy. They've rebooted Spider-Man 3 times. They reboot comic universes all the time. WWE just needs a hard reboot.
That's right. That's right.
Just a hard reboot. We'll get the new 52 every week.
Oh, man, of all the comparisons you could have
chosen.
It was the worst one.
Then we're going to have a gross, like, live sex scene between, like, John Cena and Nikki Bella in the middle of the ring with their wrestling gear wrapped around them in awkward ways.
See, that's burned into my brain. You say that, we would all fucking watch that shit.
Man.
There's already a fan fiction.
Yeah, well, yeah.
I imagine. I try not to.
We did all watch that. It was called Trainwreck.
Yeah, that's right. We did. We kind of did. Amy Schumer just got hired by the WWE. She will be the next Divas champion.
That's all right. I would watch the fuck out of that.
That's right.
She will feud with Dolph Ziggler, her ex, at WrestleMania.
I like it.
Guys.
Vince, I know you're listening.
As educational as this has been, what did you learn from wrestling this week?
Sorg, I learned that WWE shop needs to get me one of those fucking New Day unicorn horns right the fuck now. They need to sell them. I need to buy one. I need to have it. I need to wear it as I'm opening my Christmas gifts. I need that New Day unicorn horn right now. That's what I learned.
What about you, Alex Cars?
Let's see. I learned a couple things. I posted it in the Facebook group earlier. One of the things I learned is that John Cena is truly an American hero, because even he can't stand Donald Trump. The other thing I learned is that Chikara Pro, is truly the land of miracles, because only in Chikara are you going to find a woman holding the main primary championship. All hail Princess Kimberly.
Nice. Good one. What about you there, LB?
I learned that John Cena's Instagram is amazing.
Oh, yeah?
And the reason for that is because he just posts the strangest pictures imaginable, okay? And sometimes they have meaning and sometimes they don't. But I think he does it just to see what kind of meaning people will glean from it, you know? So today he pictured the logo. He posted the logo of the Today Show. Makes sense. He was on the Today Show, right? A few days ago, he posted a picture of a pepper mill.
Wait, what the hell?
Let's see here. I'm looking at this. Are we sure? GoldenEye N64 cartridge.
Oh, God, this is verified. This is definitely verified.
There's a vote for Bill Murray button.
I support that political standpoint.
There's a picture of an elephant burying its face in the surf. It's really incredible. And it's fun to see what he posts. It is just as fun to watch the madness that follows.
Look at this beard thing.
Johnson is an American hero.
Nice trademark, such feed, much goals. What the hell? WTF.
What?
The father of Sheamus. Looks like U is spelled U-I-U, or I'm sorry, Y-I-U. Goals, Sheamus. Hey is Sheamus, not too white. Sorry to sound racist. What? It's very self-identifying. Everyone is saying Sheamus, but it's obviously Zeb Kohler. I love that there's somebody with reason in here. that's a sample of 611 comments. Holy crap.
Zorg.
Can you post anything of mine, John Cena, please? Because look, elephants. Oh no. So this is definitely Barnum and Bailey's elephants that's pictured here. And then somebody asked, Thailand?
Mm-hmm.
What did they ask?
Thailand. Yeah. This is incredible. wait. Bill and Ted's excellent cereal?
Brain hurt so much.
What? This is amazing. This is the best ever. Oh, I'm following this. I'm sorry, Mike. You're about to say.
I'm here to burn. I just checked over the shop again, and I have purchased the unicorn.
Yeah, you did.
Oh, jeez.
I was not joking. I've been updating shop like roughly every 8 hours to see when this was going to go on sale, because I did not want to be part of the backordered motherfuckers.
All right. And also from...
And Macron said the safe word is unity. And that's correct.
Oh, geez. Hold on. Hold on. I got to collect myself for a moment.
Bobby also learned that the rose bush needs to be nipped in the bud. Mm-hmm. And someone needs to add the Incredible Hulk slowly walking away music to the footage of Zeb driving away from Del Rio. I would also suggest someone Photoshop Zeb backing away into the bushes like Homer Simpson.
I learned Faction Wars, man. We just tag one of the pay-per-views Gang Wars and let these four teams come at. And also, we prepared for Survivor Series a month too late at the beginning of that show this week.
I blame Seth Rollins' legs.
That's true. Garza learned that he's loving the build-up EV 3.0, the Wyatt's League of Jobbers, and Rock's Cousins. I love that Ambrose is lumped in with Rock's Cousins. Actually, Survivor Series is going to be awesome. Daniel says that WWE can't be bothered to make new stars, so they go with ECW guys. Okay, I refute that a little bit. But they debuted NXT Superstar Rhino from Garza. I didn't realize. So Alex, Cena denounced Trump on the Today Show.
Yes.
Wow. I need to watch this video later.
WWE Hall of Famer Donald Trump.
Oh no! That's right.
You forgot about that one, didn't you?
That's good. WWE Hall of Famer and Vince McMahon's really good friend Donald Trump.
Oh no! Doesn't that explain
John Cena and Lucha Underground by the end of the year?
Doesn't that explain most of WWE though?
Yeah, that's true.
Let's be honest.
It's very true. I'm not gonna lie.
Because that filters down from the top. You know what I mean? Garza also learned that WWE Female Wrestler of the Year Sasha Banks is now dancing with a fake horn on her head. Divas Revolution. Thanks, Steph. Thanks. Matt also learned Samoa Joe and Tommaso Ciampa can put on one hell of a match. Oh, yeah. And Matt also learned to never sing Drake in front of Tracy Smothers. And you can find out what that video is about at Around the Indies at indiewrestling.us. Hey. Guys!
And Sorg, hold on. I missed two from the chat room.
Okay.
Wheels learned that he is awesome at doing four jobs at once.
This is true. He didn't have a bell ringer. He didn't have an announcer helping him out. So he was doing the match times, ringing the bell for the matches, and doing sound.
Okay. I was going to assume he was in an orgy. Anyway, Matt also said that Jen Carlin's learned that she can go to a movie on Monday night and not miss anything.
Back to Wheels' point, I learned that ringing the bell is really fun because I had to help him. So I was video switching and he was having trouble hitting it. And it was one of those like kind of post-match deals. So I got the like really ring the bell like for a reason. And that is a really cool feeling. And I might quit my video to do that. Anyways, thank you, guys. It's been awesome. Thank you. I know we're a little later. Bryce Rensburg joined us on the Indie Mayhem Show. Please go check that out, WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Check out everything going out, WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Subscribe to us, live.WrestlingMayhemShow.com every Tuesday at 9 p.m. Eastern Time for 3 hours of wrestling talk and action. Actionable talking. At DJ Lunchbox and, of course, PanelRiot.com with the fantastic 50th episode that was just up. Just recently, please go listen to the whole thing. A lot of familiar voices on there.
Like mine.
We had literally everyone who's been on the show.
That's right. Including a couple guys here. And Mad Mike at Mad Mike 4883. And check out his Midweek War. Sorry that didn't get out. YouTube. So you guys did that Friday.
Mm-hmm.
YouTube just posted them.
What?
Yeah.
That's weird.
There is something wrong with YouTube. They're in processing. I couldn't get the video from YouTube to put it in any other places. So It's out there now, guys. Sorry.
Okay. Well, it was a really fun midweek war. It was me, Eamon, and Garza, and Eamon and I disagreed on Impact.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow.
So, I mean, not, you know, like Garza and I disagree on Impact, but, you know, slight disagreements.
But check in with them. Follow the YouTube and follow at Mayhem Show on the Twitter for updates on Wednesday.
Also, this week we're going to have predictions, I believe, for Final Battle and for NXT TakeOver London. So that should be fun.
Next week, you should have end of the year predictions for each show. Beyond what we do on this show.
I'm also trying to see if I can get someone who was at the ROH Nashville tapings on the show.
Ooh, look at you getting guests for this show. It's like it's a real podcast.
And it's a lady.
Oh, shit.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
And it's not whoever was Brittany in the chat room.
It's not Brittany, Alex Cars. I'm sorry. Alex Cars, add power to the Smarks. Chikara in 15 minutes or less.
Yep. Pick'em's League Season 1 is coming to kind of winding down.
Mm-hmm.
I'm getting the info ready for Season 2. That'll be starting pretty early January. In the meantime, just continue to keep an eye out at powertothesmarks.com and obviously chikara15.com. It's going to be fun.
Awesome, awesome. Of course, check out Sorgatron.com, SorgatronMedia.com for everything else going on with me. And say hi on Twitter and stuff at Sorgatron over there. Thank you so much for the chat room joining us. Wheels, Matt Carlins, Garza, and everybody else that I might have missed that popped in there throughout the evening. Bobby FJ Town hanging out as well. Check out his insertcointobegin.com for him, Rays and Chachi, talking about video games and the such and the like and the everything. We'll see you guys next time. Mayhem out. 500 next week! This show is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at sorgatronmedia.com.